watching GreenWay Startup Show, the place to be to learn how to run a business and a life you want. My name is Brigitta Balai. Are you a lawyer with dreams being a pastry chef? Or you long to be a teacher? Or you are a designer who want to do coding in the future? If you are about to change your professional life and you are older than 20 or 30, then please follow us in this show. Magdalena, welcome to the GreenWay Startup Show.
Thank you.
But today's topic is to cover how to change profession after a certain age. And we all know that, especially for women, it's not easy with a family. And I know that you have an interesting topic and an interesting life and experience, and that's why I invited for today's show you as a guest. And can you please introduce yourself?
Hi, my name is Magdalena Nemesh. I came to this country in 1989. I came as right after college as a winner of international architectural competition. I was trained as an architect, and 14 days later I defected and stayed in this country. It was in 89 and I decided to find a job in what I was trained for. And it was very difficult because I didn't know computer, I didn't know AutoCAD, and everybody said, well, you're definitely so talented, but can you draw on a computer? And I said, no. And that was kind of out of question. And then I opened my own business. I was making stuffed dolls. And I was bringing them to different stores and tried to sell them, but recession hit and nobody wanted my dolls.
Oh, you made your own dolls?
I made my own dolls, yes.
Back home?
I made them here. I made them here, and unfortunately, they weren't selling that great. And by that time, I already got married. I had a baby in 91, and I kind of was settling as a housewife. But I was it wasn't enough. It was I had dreams, and they kind of didn't let me.
So at that time when you had your family and the first child, how many years of experience you had working?
I did not really have any years of experience because I was staying home with the baby, and I was working while he was taking a nap, and I kept making my dolls, but they were not doing that great. And then I was trying to find work, but without no computer, I actually couldn't. And I was drawing, I was doing some sketches, and I was working for a small company which was doing prints on the t-shirts, but it was small and it got closed. So I still had to go back to what I wanted to do. I wanted to do something bigger, more meaningful. And at that point, I decided to learn computers. So it was very beginning.
Your passion, what was your passion at that time when you were a homestaying mom? What did you enjoy doing in your free time?
Staying at home, I'm actually taking care of the house. Didn't give much free time. But while my son was taking naps, I was painting, and I was doing some art projects, and it wasn't what I was looking for. I wanted to do something full time. I wanted to be needed by more than just my family, and I kind of became restless, and I wanted to go and learn something. And that's how I wound up in new school, a continuing education. I learned computers, and I learned from very, very beginning.
What area of computer science were you trained in? Did you learn programming? Did you learn
I was learning graphic design, and I learned basic programs which allowed me to become an art director. And I spent about 20 years doing this, and I was successful, and everything was doing great. By that time, I was already divorced and single mom, and the money was good, and the job was fun, and everything was great. But
so you had a full-time corporate job?
Yes.
And at the same time, you were a single mom.
Yes.
How did you manage this?
I don't know. It was hard. It was hard. I worked in New Jersey because my son was little, and it was easier for me to get out on time and make it to pick him up from school. But in advertising, it was never 9 to 5. I always had to stay at work, and my son learned playing chess on internet, and he learned to, he was growing in my office. I had a little pillow for him under my desk, and it was not easy.
So you brought your son into the office,
or
you
had
a
office.
You had a babysitter, or you had a family member, a grandma taking care of
him? I didn't
him?
Have a family member at that time, and he was going to after school program, but working advertising was stretching. I had 80, 90 hour weeks, and there is no way that any babysitter or anybody could handle that too. So I, after work, after office was basically getting half empty, I was able to bring him after school program to my office. And that's how he grew up. And when he became a little bit older, I was able to go and work in the city, and I was commuting to New York, and I was working in various advertising agencies. I was working on a really cool brands, on Nike, Adidas, Heineken, Molson beer. It was fun. It was very creative, and I was very happy. I was doing exactly what I wanted to do.
It sounds great. And what happened?
Recession. Recession happened, and budget started shrinking, and everything went internet and wireless and viral. And budgets were shrinking, and it was much cheaper to do internet advertising than print advertising, and that was my specialty. Budget shrunk 5 times, which means that out of 100 art directors of my colleagues kept jobs only about 20, and the rest of them have to look for something else somewhere else. And it was hard, it was competitive, and being a single parent, by that time I already had 2 children, and I was single mom again. It was very difficult. And I started looking around and see what with my skills, what else can I do? And I was looking at the social media. I decided to look in that area, and then I realized that all my colleagues will be there, and they will be as crowded as it was in advertising. And I decided to make a leap and make a step forward. And after some months and months of Googling and reading different articles and predictions, I realized that computer programming is booming, and I started thinking about it. It was very scary.
I do believe, as a woman, thinking about to shift your job and starting to do programming, it's a big decision.
It's not a big decision, it's a huge decision. Everybody said, don't do this. My dad said, don't do this. My mom said, are you crazy? My friend said, no, it's too difficult, you're too old. By that time, I was already in my late 40s, and the articles I was reading, they were saying that if you're after 25 or after 30, it's very difficult. It's a male-dominated business. You really have to compete with people who do it since they're teenagers. They're all young, and it's close to impossible.
And it's not only the age, but also the that it's a globalized world, meaning that most of the programming and IT jobs are outsourced to Asia or any like other countries. So mainly they are not done in the US.
Yes, and that is a challenging too. So reinventing myself, I was thinking, well, how can I beat that competition? So I found a website called Odesk, and I found out that there are many computer programmers working for very little money, and they're offering their services for so cheap overseas that it is a shame to even start thinking about it. But I thought, well, you know what, if this is the start, this is the start. After all, there are some non-paid internship anyway. So I was thinking about that, and by that time I already wasn't working in advertising. I had my own little design bureau, which wasn't doing that great in terms of revenue. I could barely make it, and I was working in a restaurant.
Okay, so you had a part-time job.
I had a part-time job. Saturdays and Sundays, I was working in the restaurant as a hostess, and I decided to go to learn programming by myself. It was very difficult. I could not pull it off. I didn't know anybody. I was outsider, and I didn't have any technical degree or any math. I was trained as an architect. People look at us as non-technical people, and this is a mindset. This is the kind of angle we are looked at, but at the same time, this is how we are sort of conditioned. One of the difficult parts was to actually start thinking of myself as I can do it. I can learn it. I can just, maybe I should pretend first that I can do it, and then I will really be able to do it. So I I tried different things.
So how did you get all of this energy and motivation inside of you to go against all the opinions and just decide and to go for it?
This is where actually kids come and play. When I hear, "Mom, I'm hungry. Mom, I need new sneakers." This is a driving force.
At the time when you decided to make this move, how old were you?
I was 48. Yeah, which is a completely unacceptable age to start learning program. Yes, it was people nice and polite started saying that it's not the right age. Basically, they were saying, "You're too old." And what really helped me is that I was eating healthy, staying fit, and I didn't look that old. So I kind of felt young too, and that helped a lot. That helped a lot. So
yeah, even myself, if you would ask me, I would never be able to tell that you are in your 50s.
Well, what really helps to transition career as well as do any to achieve any sort of success is kind of maintaining emotional fitness and physical fitness, eat healthy, and then you look better, you look younger, you think better, and that is helping too. Apparently, I know that I couldn't leave my children any fortune or trust fund, but I could teach them read, educate themselves continuously, and I can also I also taught them to eat healthy food. And my son graduated Rutgers University a year ago with a degree in nutrition. So he's actually, it was a good effort, and now he is continuing this sort of healthy lifestyle and healthy mindset.
So you are meditating, you are eating healthy, and you do sport regularly, if I understand you correctly.
Well, I don't go to a gym because I don't have time, but I work out every morning and every evening, and it's just 10-15 minutes. And my daughter, she's 12, she does that too.
So she's following her mom, right? And doing the exercises with you?
Yes. Yes, we do it together, and
it's
a good habit.
Do you have a video, or you just done on YouTube something? And
no, I actually have an orange belt in karate. And she has orange belt too. My son was doing karate for many years. He has black belt. And this is a very good sport, which actually you can do at home. It's a very not time consuming routine.
You save time, you save money, right? So your example basically shows me and proves me that if we would like to make a change, everything is possible.
I believe in it.
You always find a way if you really decide to go for something and achieve your dreams. You always can do that as long as you go for your dreams and you work on that.
Yes, I believe so. I believe in dreams, I believe in happy ending, and I believe in magic, and magic always happens at the end. You just need to believe and work toward. Sometimes it is very hard. Sometimes it's time consuming, and sometimes I want to give up, but I was thinking, well, I can always give up tomorrow. Why don't I try harder today? And eventually it works. And the same thing I could apply to learning. It was very difficult to learn and work at the same time. I was not at home 7 days a week. It was very difficult to go to school and then study at night, and then Saturday and Sunday go to work and do it over and over and over again. And at the end, it paid off. It paid off. At the end, I graduated a boot camp in the city. It's a turn-to-tech school. And my second resume and my very first resume got me a job.
Oh, congratulations for that.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, it was a magic. I was the first one out of batch of our graduates, and it worked. That magic actually happened.
So after 6 month training, or how long this boot camp was?
Boot camp lasts about 3 months.
Okay.
But I consider Googling and actually figuring out what to do and kind of setting my mind on the goals also training, because if we're not ready to do a change and transition, if we are kind of have sort of unfinished business in the other career and we're still looking back, it's very difficult.
Mm-hmm.
We really have to invest everything, all 100% in our new dream, in our new goal, and then it works. So altogether, it was about a year of preparation, learning, then trying and failing by myself, then thinking and rethinking, making different decisions, and actually going to school. It's about a year.
Did you get a full scholarship for this?
No, I had to work very hard. Basically, I was giving most of my paycheck to pay for this school, and it was very difficult. It was very difficult. Both of my children's fathers did not pay child support. We have our lights turned off. We have been evicted. We had no heat in February. Our phones were off, and I still kept pushing and pushing and pushing, and at the end, it happened.
So who was on your side who helped you to stand up every single day and say that I don't give up, I keep continue doing it?
You know, at the end, actually, I was alone. As sad as it is, most of my friends said, well, it's too difficult, you cannot do it, and they're just watching me. Many friends even kind of sort of distance themselves. Well, she's crazy, what is she doing? And basically, my kids and my cats were my biggest support. Yeah, it was that unconditional love and beliefs that that mommy can do it, help me.
So your kids fully supported your dreams and
yes.
Your plan? Even when there were like difficult times.
Yes.
And where do you see yourself in a year from today?
Well, I started working in corporate America, and I was sort of back in the game, but in a different place, on a different planet, and doing different things. And of course, it was very, very thrilling for me to, you know, to be able to work again in a full capacity and give all 100% of my thinking ability and just pursue my dream. But I was so tired that I was just, all I wanted is just to have a job.
Mm-hmm.
But when I got into this business, I realized there were so many interesting things happening there. There are so many interesting possibilities and opportunities. My dream started cooking again, and I decided to open my own business. Consulting, and I'm thinking about it now. I have some really good ideas, and I work as a contractor. So my contract expires in about 6 months. So I'm thinking that there is quite possible that I will continue doing it on my own, because in 6 months working, I never stopped learning. I am coming home every day, and I will do this tonight too. An hour or two or three, as much as I can. I keep learning new programming languages, new software. I keep reading all the time, and that really helps me to widen my horizon. And you know, I'm competing on the market with people who are who have a computer science degree, and I don't have one, and I don't think I ever will. But as my dad said, that the best education is self-education, and I feel like I still need to learn a
mm-hmm.
lot, and by the time I learn what I wanted to learn, there will be so much new to learn that I probably will never stop learning. But based on what I learned already, I realize that there is so much opportunities for individual right now to even open your own business and a company or a group of people. There are so many startups that besides being it's hot and fashionable, there is a sense. There is a sense when people can pursue their dreams and see results, and technology makes it happen very quickly.
So you have to share your secret with me, that how can you compete for a position with young people, men with an IT degree, if there are two resumes on the table? How did you manage to get a job and get hired? What was your secret?
This is actually not a secret, but actually it is. It derives from my path. I wanted to have a skill which allows me to compete and survive and succeed. And I kind of set up the goal of what I wanted to do, and I tried to figure out what I need to learn for that. And as a result of a lot of Googling, I figured out, okay, if I want to do this, I need to learn this. And if I want to learn that one, it's too difficult, so I have to learn something else before, and something else. So I broke it down all the way to the very beginning, and I started learning the easiest language for beginners. Mm-hmm. And then I was a little bit, I was learning next something more complicated, next level. And when they saw it on my resume, they realized that actually it's not that I was concentrating on one thing, I was just learning as much as I could. And because of the low budget, I was and very, very welcoming New York open source community, there are many, many resources for women and for beginners right now to take either low cost or free classes or workshops. And that what really helped me. So I wasn't really looking at on concentrating in something very, very narrow specializing. I was just taking whatever there was, as long as it was free or cheap. And this way I learned a lot. And when mm-hmm. they saw this on my resume, they asked me, how did Python wound up on your resume? And I said, well, it was free, so I took it. And actually it helped me later to learn other languages, which are very good and very marketable. And they hired me. They actually, this is kind of a magic story. They hired me and they gave me a chance, because programming languages they were hiring me for, I did not know. They asked me, do you know that? And I said, no. Did you know that? And I said, no. I was able to answer technical questions in general, and I answered them correct. But they said, well, if you know that, you can pull it off. And I had to learn it all over again. And I learned it from scratch, and I had to learn it very fast. And that's how the habit of studying at night every day never left me since then. And I'm still learning. And that's what really helped me, because they just gave me a chance and I didn't blow it. That I just really, really, really pushed it very hard.
Okay, to conclude your secret, I would say your secret is discipline. That you always keep going and you never give up. So if I would ask you to give two recommendations for women who are in a very similar situation as you have been before, single moms, don't really see a positive outcome for their future and for their job, what would you recommend for these women, how to start? And where to start to change a career?
Well, first of all, they need to read a little bit about industry and see if they can use their previous experience. There is always something they can use as a base. If they can't use it as a base, they're always troubleshooting a life experience, which also helps them. And second is that computer doesn't really care whether it's a man or a woman pushes the button. It doesn't matter. It's a world of zeros and ones. And as long as you push the right button, computer doesn't care. And if you're good at this, the company doesn't really care that much.
I can confirm that as a woman in IT, I'm also in IT world, and I can confirm that I think women doing computer job, it just shakes up this world a little bit, because men need also women on their side and have the things going.
Well, I can tell you, being the only woman in a department of 11 coders, I created quite a commotion, and it took them some time to adjust to me. And actually, from not saying hello at all, it went into actually giving me advice and asking for help and being very nice to me.
Mm-hmm.
So by hardworking and just working hard and showing my willingness to learn, it changed. It changed, and I believe in change, that we can change it, and just don't give up. Just don't give up, keep believing in yourself, and that is the best start.
Mm-hmm. Magdalena, thank you very much for being here today.
Thank you for inviting me. I hope that at some point my words help at least some of us to change it and not to be afraid.
Yes. If anybody from the audience would like to reach out to you, I can give your email address, I hope.
Yes, sure. Yes.
Thank
yes.
you very much for being here and
you're welcome, and
sharing
thank you for
your experience
me.
And helping, motivating other women as well to change their professional life.
Thank you, too. Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.